Hello everybody and welcome to Going for Goldbridge. First of all, I just want to say cheers, it's Friday. All the pubs are closing and I saw some interesting things today, but it's getting really interesting, isn't it? I just want to show you this actually. I wonder if it will show up all right. Found that today. 23 years old on the shots. In a pub. So all the pubs are closed, all the cinemas are closed, all the restaurants are closed, all the gyms are closed, all the leisure centres are closed, and it suddenly feels quite real. I know this has been happening in other countries, I know it was happening in Ireland, but I think that the way I've dealt with this today is that it's another step towards what we need to do, but it's another step towards depression. And it is depression, and I think we need to absolutely own that, because I've always said on Going for Goldbridge when I used to do it weekly that depression affects everybody, and I suppose mental health affects everybody. It's just how you deal with it and how deep it goes. And there's no other way of looking at this, that we are definitely depressed, aren't we? Because we're losing things that we want really, really badly, and we're not getting them, and we're not going to get them for however long. So there is an element of depression there. But what I would say is that you never know what life is going to throw up to you. And I saw some interesting things today that have happened with regards to the rules. Hello, you want to come over? Do you want to come on? It's very, very quick. Yeah. Quick then, come on. We're on. Daddy's doing a show. Come to that. Come on. Come here. Quick. He might come on here. Come on then. Quick. Come and have a look at yourself. Come on. There he is. Hello. I see it. Yeah. Are you going to stay? Or do you want to go and find mummy? I think she's upstairs. Okay. Did she get your milk? Yeah, so it's been a funny day, and I went into the shops this morning and just to try and find some toilet roll and stuff like that, which I'm sure is going to be fine in the future. I'm sure it will be fine. But I went into Marks & Spencer's Food, and people are like, oh, you must be doing quite well in life. No, I went into Aldi first, and there was nothing in there. So I went round to M&S, and as to get into the food store at M&S, which is Marks & Spencer's, for those people who don't live in the UK, M&S food is a bit more expensive. And I walked through the clothing section, they had a sale on. And it wasn't, I wouldn't say, I'm not going to lie and say it was rammed, because that's not the truth, but it was busy, and it was busy with people over 70. And I thought, hold on a minute. We're all meant to be cutting back here, and we're mainly cutting back to prevent and protect people who are elderly and have health conditions. And here we are, and we've already started. Today is no surprise that people should be working from home if they can do, and isolating themselves when they can do, especially from elderly relatives. I don't see my relatives. And I go into my M&S, and there they all are, buying clothes. And somebody said to me, well, maybe they need clothes. What a load of nonsense. There's a sale on and they can't help themselves being out of a routine. They can't get out of the routine, so they've gone in and they bought clothes. And I'm not taking a pop at them. I'm just saying people have got to get out into this mindset. We ain't got football. We ain't got pubs. We can't go and see our families. We can't go out for a Mother's Day meal on Sunday. So people need to get this mentality. But I just found it weird today that you go into a shop and there is loads and loads of people over 70 shopping amongst each other. And you think, you know, we've got to get our mindset, and we've got to get our heads on here, of course. But look, yeah, for the UK, pubs are closed, restaurants are closed, all that, as I've said before. And I think this, for me, is a real thing. And I did tweet it out before, and I said, look, you know, tonight, I've known it's coming. For me, it was never novelty. I wasn't one of those people last week who were saying, because like all the kids have finished school today as well. I know people who didn't send their kids to school this week because they didn't believe in it. Well, that's up to them. But you know, my personal opinion is that that's novelty, because you think, oh, I've got to stop them. In 2 weeks, you're going to be fed up with this world. We all are. And I think that the last grab of normality before it goes, I never had a problem with it. I think the timing of everything has been more or less right. Maybe a couple of days here, maybe a couple of days there, but not terribly wrong. And I feel an anxiety that, you know, all the pubs and everything are closing tonight, because it's like that is normal. I don't go to the pub every Friday night, far from it, but they're always there as an option. The cinema's always there as an option. to have those things taken away is very odd. It's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world. You know, we've still got our houses. We've still got things. But I think the people I do worry about are the people who are on their own. There's a lot of people. I used to live on my own. There's a lot of people who live on their own. And I think that hopefully this and interaction with people on WhatsApp groups, on chats, everything like that, as long as they're, you know, don't go on the dodgy ones, but you know what I mean. Very important. Very important. I've had a few messages from people today that we don't normally message each other, but we've had that sort of back and forth to say, let's message each other a lot more now because you're probably going through what I'm going through. And I think that's that unity and synergy is very important, isn't it? Because we are all going through something here. Very, very rare in life that we all go through something. I think the only times I can think of is, and it's in a nice way, is when it's Christmas. We all, a lot of us celebrate Christmas Day, so we all celebrate something together. And this is far from that. It's very much, as I said before, it's a Poundland Christmas. It's not a nice, you know, tree up and everything like that. But everybody is going through it together. And therefore, I think it's very important that everybody keeps in contact with each other, maybe more than they ever would do, because our lives are not going to be as busy. I was saying this to somebody when they were cutting my hair yesterday. I said, look, last Saturday was difficult because it's not, you know, the things you take for granted. Like, I take my daughter to play football on a Saturday morning, horse riding for my oldest daughter, swimming with Seb, who you just saw there. Not necessarily me doing all that. The wife does it, or we do it together, etc. But there's not many hours where everybody's in the house together, and that's going to be very, very difficult. I suppose that slipped out. It's going to be very different, is what I meant to say. But you know what? There's a story I want to tell you here, and I should have told you at the start. There's a story I want to tell you, and this really does demonstrate how unpredictable life is, and how a different path can send on something positive. Because I think I've said this, and it's not a cliche. We're going to war as a human race. We're going to war. And we will win this battle. I'm 100% convinced we're going to win this battle. There will be casualties along the way. Some people won't be coming out the other side of it. Hopefully not many, but hopefully most of us will come out of it. But there will be a battle and there will be a war, and we will win this war. But we will come out of it never the same again, because we will always know that this can happen now. And as I said on a previous video, this was always a rumour. Oh yeah, it won't happen. It's happened. You know, it's happened. Worldwide flights, everything, it's happened. And it shows what many people actually believe anyway, that we are only the occupiers of this planet. It's not ours, and we've treated it like ours, and it's not. And this is an eye-opener to the fact that no matter how much we develop, no matter how powerful we think we are, we can be took out very, very quickly. I mean, let's be honest, if this strain was stronger and attacked everybody, we could wipe most of us out. So it's not that, but we are going to go through something here that we never thought we were going to go through, and we'll come out of it different. And I think what I'm going to story tell you now is, hopefully we can come out of it stronger, because this is a small story, but a big story. So we were out on a night out once, and me and two of my mates, like best mates, and we're about 17 years of age, and we were out in Nottingham, and we'd had a really good time, and I don't remember the exact details, but I think a couple of my mates were trying to pull this girl, and I wasn't really getting involved in it because I just wasn't interested. I think I must have had a girlfriend at the time, so I was just out. And they got into a bit of an argument in the bar, and it was a bit pushy and shovey. It's always embarrassing in a pub when two people start fighting and they're your mates, and everyone else is breaking them up, and you're trying to go, yeah, but they're mates. But then somebody, you probably might not have been in this situation, but I'm sure you can imagine it. So you're out in a three, two of your mates start fighting, you're trying to break it up, and then somebody who's nothing to do with it, Hero Harry, jumps in and starts pushing you away. So I'm sorting it. You're going, they're my best mates. And anyway, we got separated. They went outside, and I went with one of my mates, and the other mate just bloody was really, really angry. Anyway, calmed down a bit. They got back together. I said, look, we'll go to the pub in a minute. It's only like 11:30. Let's go and have something to eat and then calm down. And so we went to this Burger King, and I think it was actually, I'm trying to think where it was. It was next to Victoria Centre in Nottingham, so it may have been KFC. Anyway, the toilets were downstairs there. So me and my mate, I might as well tell you the name, Gaz, we went downstairs into the toilet. I don't know how this happened, but we're in the toilet. There's nothing like that. No, there was nothing like that. We went into the toilet, and we just stood there in the toilet having a chat, and he's going, "Oh, Andy's a fucking idiot. He's always a stupid twat. He's always about him when he's had a drink. Like, he knew I liked her, and he's had to stick his nose in. He's got no loyalty to his mate. He's a fucking idiot." Right. And I'm sort of going, yeah, he was bang out of order. He's a bit of a prat, really, but, you know, you shouldn't be doing that. Anyway, next thing you know, the toilet bloody cubicle opens. He comes out. He goes, "You two can piss off. I'm done with you." We're like, one, how unlucky is that? Two, how was he even in here when we'd left him upstairs? It was just odd. I don't know how he ended up being in there. Anyway, we like look at each other and go, "Oh, sod this. Let's go to Riley's and play snooker and have a drink." So we went out. We got up there and he wasn't there. We went outside. Couldn't see him. Walked out. Just walking along the road. And the next thing, I spotted him come running across this main road towards us. Swings at me. I ducked it. And then just runs straight into the shop window and nearly knocks himself out. Gaz then just starts hitting him on the floor. So I'm like, and then another load of other lads come over who see what's happening and just break it up, and I break it up, and I'm just like, this is one of the most surreal things I've ever had. He swung a punch at me. I'm soberer than him. I've ducked it. He's gone into the shop window with momentum of running across the road, nearly knocked himself out. Gaz has gone for him on the floor, obviously pissed off that he's tried to attack us. Then it's been broken up again. Anyway, we still went and played snooker, but the story is that we didn't talk to this friend for quite a long time afterwards, and that night while we were playing snooker, we were like, sod this, it's July, let's just go and have a holiday. So we went off on a holiday, which we never were going to do. If the three of us, I guarantee if three of us had done it, we would have gone to Ibiza, right? But we went to Mallorca. Went to Mallorca, met these Irish girls, ended up having a long distance relationship, moved over to Ireland, was with that girl for 2 years, met my current wife, here we are now. Now, if that thing had not happened on that night like that, if he'd not been in that cubicle, or they'd not even further take it back, if they'd not had that argument about that girl, and I'd not said, calm down, let's go to KFC, whatever it is, and he'd not been in the cubicle hearing what we're saying, to then do what he did on the street, we would never have, we were always as a three, and we would never have gone to Mallorca, and I know we wouldn't have gone to Mallorca, but because of all that, me and my mate went to Mallorca, and my life whole changed. So it's that butterfly effect, and it's so true, fate. It's so true. And I just think that, yeah, we're in a situation at the moment now where it's weird. It's definitely weird, and it's definitely unplanned for, and it's definitely not what we want, but it could be the butterfly effect that changes everything. And I've had a few people messaging me today because I put a tweet out saying that, you know, we're all going to struggle here. How are you all feeling? And I had some people sending me direct messages and everything like that. And I think the most important thing here is to be open, to talk, to get messaging your mates and everything like that, but also to try and be creative with your time. Like, read that book that you never read. Play that computer game campaign that you never played. You know, put that shelf up that you never put your shelf up. Clear that garage out that you never cleared. Like, be creative with your time. I mean, look, some of the things I've got planned already, because I've got loads of stuff planned, because I'm normally day-to-day very, very busy, and I still am going to be. I'm still doing this stuff. I've got my FIFA career mode, I've got United Stand, but it's not going to be as busy, because there's not, although I'm going to be doing more on this channel and more on FIFA, and United Stand will still be more or less the same. There's not matches, there's not press conferences, there's not meetings, there's a lot of things that aren't happening. So I'm probably going to be, although on camera I look as busy as I've ever been, 50% of my time less. Which means I can watch the Lord of the Rings trilogy, I can watch the Hobbit trilogy, I can watch the Batman trilogy, I can watch all of the Star Wars, because then, you know, Rise of Skywalker is going to be out soon, I can watch all 9 films. There's loads of box sets I want to watch. So those things to me are important. There's books I want to read. There is DIY I want to do. So there's walks I want to go on. You know, I'm not that far away that I can go for a little bit of a drive into the country and have a walk. I'm going to take the family with you. So there's things that we can do, and hopefully, you know what, 12 weeks, 6 weeks, 20 weeks, whatever, we will get used to it, and I think that's what we need to do. So I'm really enjoying doing these things, and I hope that I just wanted to do a quick one tonight, because it's been a weird week. We're a week on from where it really started, and I think now we're going to hit that wall of it's going to become very real, and it's going to become very consistent and persistent. So But the big thing I want to say is we're all in the same boat. We are all in the same boat. I said this before, the twats and trolls on social media will get worse because they were already to be a troll and a hater, you've already got to be pretty self-loathing anyway. They're going to get worse. Feel sorry for them. You know, if they're causing trouble and they're being haters on social media or anything like that at a time like this, it only exposes how unhappy they were before and how even more unhappy they are now. Don't let them drag you down. Focus on the good people and let's work through it together. Because, you know, as I said, you could say this is an illness for all of us, and it will be a real illness for some of us. But the actual deprivation of what's happening in our society, we will all feel these symptoms. We're all going to feel a bit confused. We're all going to feel a little bit low. We're all going to feel a little bit depressed. And we're all going to feel very, very uncertain about what's going on because everything is uncertain. But remember, we all feel this. So if you're thinking about it, staying awake at night thinking about it, waking up early, you know, we're all feeling it. So not always in life do you have something bad and everyone else feels it. You know, you think about it. If you've got something wrong with you, has anyone else got that at work, you know, or a family member? We can all relate to this. We've just got to communicate about it. Anyway, thanks everyone for watching. Please do smash a like on the video. Back again tomorrow. And look, I hope you're enjoying the videos. They're very useful for me as a sort of daily sort of vlog chat thing. There's so much changing every day. But let's stay together, united, and we will come through this. But the battle is just beginning in many ways. And with every day we get through, every day we get closer to the end of it. Thanks for watching. Speak to you soon.